The generation of Lot who is called Latin, better known as the Italians and the Latin people, and the people who were the descendants of the Moabites and Ben-Amites, and whose forefathers were from an incestuous origin. And these were the sons of the Horites, whom were otherwise known as the Latin people, and who are today called the Italians, and are the people who are now living in the nation of Italy today. Genesis 36:22, and the children of Lot, were better known as descendants of Lotan and the Latin people, the Italians who were Hori and Hemam and Lotan's sister whom was called Timnah. Genesis 14:6, and the Horites people I believed lived before times in Haran, which was by the wilderness of El Paran, before they moved to Italy to lived, which I believe is Mount Seir, and which was called Seirath, and which was a part of Edomia. Genesis 36:20, and these were the sons of Lot who moved to Seir. And they were the Horites, who were called the Horims or the cave dwellers, whom were known as the Troglodyte people, whom were cave dwellers and who were people like the descendants of Lot, and any members of any person or cave dwellers, especially like those in antiquity, and of those, like the descendants of Lot, who lived in caves or from those who were reputed to have lived chiefly in caves, and whom were the inhabitants of the land, of Mount Seir, and these were the Latin people, like, Lotan, and Shobal, and Zibeon, and Anna. Genesis 36:21 and Dishon, and Ezer, and Dishan, and these were the dukes of the Horites who were the children of Lot, better known as Latin and the descendants of the Italian people of today, who were living in Seir or Seirath, which nowadays some believe is the land of Italia. And who were the descendants of the Lot and the nephew of Abraham. And who were living in the land of Haran. Before they came to live in Edom. Which was then called by the name, Edomia. Genesis 36:22, and the children of Lot, better known as the Latin people who were also the descendants of Lot in whom, were Hori, and Hemam, and Lotan's sister who was called Timnah. Genesis 36:23, and the children of Shobal were these, Aluan, and Manahath, and Ebal, Shepho, and Onam. Genesis 36:24, and these are the children of Zibeon, both Ada and Anna, and this was that same Anna who found the mules in the wilderness, as he fed the asses of Zibeon his father. Genesis 36:25, and the children of Anna were these, Dishon, and Ahalabama, and all the grandchildren of Anna whose grandchildren were of the wives of Esau, and from Ada who was the mother of Aholah and Ahalabah, and it was the sons of Ahalabah who were the founding fathers of the city of Jerush and Alam, which is called Jerusalem today, and which was before times called the city of Rome. And I believe that it was also the descendants of Lotan, probably, one of the sons of Ezer, possibly Jochin, who was also called Achan or Achbar, that was the founding fathers of the city of Pi, or Pai, which is better known as the city of Paris, France. Genesis 36:26, and these are the children of Dishon, Hemdan and Eshbon, and Iathran, and Charan. Genesis 36:27 The children of Ezer are these, Bilhan or Baal-Hanan and Zoan or Hadad and Achan or Jachin. Genesis 36:28 And the children of Dishan are these, Uz and Aran. Genesis 36:29 These are the dukes that came of the Horites, Duke Lotan, Duke Shobal, Duke Zibeon, Duke Anna, Genesis 36:30 and Duke Dishan, and Duke Ezer, and from Duke Ezer, Jachin, and these are the dukes that came from Hori, among their dukes in the land of Seir. Judges 3:5, and the children of Uriel, they dwelt among the Canaanites, who were the Hittites, and the Amorites, and the Perizzites, and the Hivites, and Jebusites, and the Horites. And also the Ammonites and the Moabites and Amalekites and the others. Judges 3:15, but when the children of Israel were in distress they cried to Elohim, the sovereign of their forefathers and Elohim, used a deliverer by the name of, Ehud, who was the son of Gera, and who was a Ben-Amit, and who were from the sons of Ben-Ammi, whom was one of the incessant son of Lot, and a Canaanite, and who was a left-handed man, and by whom the children of Israel, sent a present to, which was a bribe to go up and kill Eglon the king of Moab. And these were the people whom Esau chose to get married into. And Esau also had children with the other Canaanite nations, like the Hittites and Horites, whom were from the Italian nation, people whom were from an incestuous and an ancestral origin. And in this case from the people of Lot and the sons of Lot, whom were the Moabites and the Ben-Amites. And the children of Israel embraced the Canaanites and the people who were also from the Hittites and the Hivites and the Jebusites and the Ammonites and the Amalekites and the Moabites, of whom the children of Israel were admonished by Moses, that they shouldn't marry into, because this was a commandment from Elohim, that they should not intermarry with any Canaanites, or with any Canaanite nations. And they were not even supposed to dwell with them. And they were explicitly told to drive them out. Because they were a corrupt people, and because they were worshippers of idols and they served Baal, and Gog God, whom is called Satan, with their idol worship, and they were warned that, if they did so, and if they were to accept them and were to embrace them that these nation them, that they would lead them astray from Elohim. And that by them also worshipping their false gods, like Gog God Gadriel, who is called Satan, and Baal God, who is called Jesuit Judas Jesus, and the other numerable paganistic gods, such as those of the Elmari hedonistic religion and others, that Elohim would forsake them. Friends, during the times of the reign of the kings of Israel, there were idol worship, and the worshipping of Baal, and the worshipping of the other hedonistic gods such as Dagon and Chemosh and Astaroth and Baalim and the false other gods, that the people of Israel was worshipping. And this was when Elohim called the prophet Amos and Hosea to prophesy to the houses of Israel and to say, to them, that the kingdom of Israel, and that of Judah, whom is called Weyadah, that they would be dissolved, and that the people of Israel, and also Judah, that they were going to be removed from their land and that they would go into captivity, and that the monarchy was going to be taken away from them and even from the city of Jerusalem, which was before times called the city of Rome. Here is the quote from the book of Amos and Hosea, Amos 7:8, and then the sovereign one, who is called Elohim, said to me, Amos, Amos, what do you see? And I said, to Elohim a plumb line. Then he said to me, behold, I, Elohim, will set a plumb line in the midst of me and my people who are called Israel. And I shall forsake them, and I will not pass by them any more. And when I return again, I will gather Judah again. And I will establish my kingdom in the earth. Amos 7:9, and the high places of Isaac shall be desolate, and the sanctuaries of Israel shall be laid to waste, because of the whoredom and the idolatry of old Gog God Gadriel, who is called Satan, and the lordolatry of Baal in the houses of Baal, whom I Elohim will cause to cease. And that, the Seir, Ehu, will become king, and he will rise up against the house of Jeroboam with the sword, and against the houses of Baal, and also against the kings of Israel, and their kingdom would be dissolved, and the monarchy would be removed, even from Jerusalem, which was before times called Rome. Amos 7:10, then Amaziah the priest of Bethel sent a message to Jeroboam king of Israel, saying these prophecies of Elohim which he had prophesied, and that how Amos had conspired against them, and that the kingdom that were in the midst of Israel, that they would be dissolved, and that the land is not able to bear all the words and the prophecies of Elohim. Amos 7:11, for thus Amos says that he says that Jeroboam shall die by the sword, and that Israel shall surely be led away captive, out of their own land. And also Elohim came and spoke to Hosea in the days of the kings of Israel, and in the time of Jeroboam, the son of Nebat, who built idols in Israel, and in Bethel and also in Dan with their groves and with their high places in their cities, and they were placed in places which caused the people of Elohim to go a-whoring after them and also after Baal, the Canaanite god, Gog God. And this caused the people to go a-whoring after them and to commit idol worship. and also the worshipping of Gog god Gadriel, whom is called the serpent, and Satan, which was then called idolatry. And Jehoahaz, who was one of the sons of Joash and the son of Ehu, who acted to rid the whoredoms and the idolatry of the people of Israel, and also the worshipping of Baal, in the houses of Baal from throughout the Israelis nation them, and from among the people who had departed from Elohim. With their provocation and with their whoredom and with their idol worship and with their vanities. Hosea 1:2, and in the beginning when Elohim came to Amos, and Hosea, then, Elohim began to say to Hosea, Hosea, you go and you, take a wife who is a whore, and you take one from one of the houses of whoredom, and you take one from the lands of the people who are committing whoredom, and you take a wife from they who have departed from Elohim Elu, who is also called Elohim, whom is the true sovereign one, and who is also called Elohim. Hosea 1:3, so Hosea went and took the blame from the sons of Gomer, and from the daughters of Ashkenaz, who then conceived and bare him a son. Hosea 1:4, and then Elohim said to him, call his name Israel. Because yet a little while, and I Elohim will avenge the blood of my people who are also called Israel, and I Elohim will avenge Israel blood upon the house of Baal. And I Elohim Israel will cause the kingdom and the house of Baal and also the two Israel to cease. Hosea 1:5, and it shall come to pass in the day, in the end times, that I Elohim Israel will break the bows and weapons and the swords of Baal and of Gog god and Gomer, and the sons of Gomer and of both Israel. And also all the other nations them that are with them in the valley of Israel. Friends, the sons of Lot, better known as the Latin people, or the Italians, whom were also descendants of Latin, and his sons and daughters, were also called Jesuits and Jesuites, and they too would be judged by Elohim in the latter days. Friends, I supposed that this message that it won't be well received. And the Jesuits and the Jesuites, they would sorter be up in arms. Because, who would ever think that, Lotan is a descendant of Lot, and that he was the nephew of Abraham. And who are called the Latin people, or the Italians, and that the Latin people have an incestuous roots of being Canaanites, and that they might take offense to that, and also, of being labeled as Canaanites, and whose forefather is actually the nephew of Abraham who was called Lot. And whose sons and daughters that they are now deeply rooted in Jesuitism and Judaism and idolatry and paganism and pantheism. And that they are now the fathers of the churches of Christendom, and that they are also the founding father of the Church of Gesu. And also the perpetrators of the organizations of the abominations in the earth, and the worshipping of Baal, who is the Lord, whom is better known as Jesus. And the Canaanite god Gog, whom is otherwise known as Satan. Friends, there's no wonder that the churches of Christendom and the societies of Gesu, otherwise known as the Church of Isis and Jesus and IHS and Yeshua and Yeshua, that they have permeated the fabric of every nation with their societies in the whole wide world. And it is because of the blasphemy of old Gog god Gadriel, whom is called the serpent of old, and Satan, and his sons, the Lord, known as Jesus, Jesuit Judas, with their lordolatry and with the idolatry of old Gog god and Jesuit Judas Jesus in the world, and that's why sin is so rampant in today's world. And that's why the sovereign one, whom is called Elohim, would come down from heaven once more to punish old Gog god Gadriel and his sons, and the children of disobedience. And Elohim shall establish a holy nation and a holy kingdom and a holy city and an holy people in the earth for himself. And Elohim shall rule and reign in the world as the only one true, sovereign king. Hallel, Elu. Iyah. Amen. Friends, if you now see the sin of blasphemy and the turmoil and the deceit and the deception of old Gog god Gadriel, and the idolatry and the lordolatry of his son Jesuit Judas Jesus in this world, and in Christendom, and within the innumerable religions that are in this world today, would you now return to the sovereign of heaven and the earth who is called Elohim before, the Holy One, comes? Friend. And if you now seen the reality of what was prophesied by Elohim,